it makes sense that if we are really trying to make sure every Pennsylvania who's legally able and meets our requirements to vote, that they have every opportunity to have their say at the polling places on Election Day. I also want to be clear, when the proponents of the need for this voter ID, voter suppression bill, when they express the whole thing around fraud happening at our polling places, let's be clear, we already show ID when we register. When you first come in to register, first time participating in the electoral process, you have to show your ID. This bill really, in my opinion, targets those individuals who have been voting faithfully year after year after year, who've become known in our polling places. How many of us have shown into polling places and we've seen those same workers at the table, the judges of elections, all of those nice young men, old men, women at the tables, and they know you by name. They've seen you year after year after year. Now this bill says to them and to you that even though you've been going here for the last 15, 20, 30, or 40 years, and you've gotten to know those people at those tables, that somehow they're not equipped and qualified to see if you're actually the person on the card whose name it is who's qualified to vote. I think that is a suppression. I think that is a direct attack on voters who have followed the law, who have faithfully shown themselves diligent in trying to be full citizens. I think it also targets those individuals who are new to this process, maybe registered 1-2 years ago and have just started on their way to being full participants in our democracy. And they're already a little nervous, already have been a little nervous about the process and how they develop themselves into a full citizen. Now this process is saying, on top of you showing your ID when you first registered or when you first came to vote, each and every time you have to show your ID. And if you've moved and their ID doesn't reflect that address, even though we know that you now have been voting in this polling place for the last couple years, you still won't be able to vote. You have to have this extra step, go down and prove that your address is now what we knew it was before. It's just another step. These are barriers to allowing people to vote. And again, if you have low voting turnout already in the climate that we have, you're only gonna have lower numbers. And again, lower numbers don't hurt just those individuals who aren't allowed to vote on that day. They hurt our whole society. So again, I would hope that these sensible reforms that Dan has put before us will get a fair hearing and passage. And I also hope that we will eventually repeal this bill, this law, the voter ID law, and allow for full democracy to take place. So thank